Achieving gender equality is still 300 years away. United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres issued that warning in an address before the UN Commission on Status of Women. He says progress on women's rights have slowed as he cited mounting cases of abuses against women and girls all over the world. These include maternal mortality, violation of sexual rights, and the lack of education and job opportunities.
Gender equality is growing more distant. On the current track, where Newman puts it 300 years away, maternal mortality is increasing. One woman dies every 2 minutes during pregnancy or childbirth. Most of these deaths are preventable. The impact of the COVID-19 pandemic continues for millions of girls forced out of school, mothers and caregivers forced out of paid employment, and children forced into early marriage.
Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau orders new investigations into China's alleged election meddling. He will appoint an independent special rapporteur to lead the probes on Canada's 2021 and 2019 polls. An eminent Canadian to the
position of Now, some people have argued strongly that a public inquiry is the necessary next step. Some others have pointed out the flaws and challenges of a public inquiry. That's why we will ask the independent special rapporteur, as one of the first tasks of their mandate, to provide the government with a recommendation as to what the appropriate next step should be, whether it be an inquiry, an investigation, or a judicial review, and what the scope of that work may be. And we will abide by their recommendation.
Trudeau and Canada's top security officials have acknowledged interference attempts by China, but they insist election outcomes were not altered. China, meanwhile, denies the allegations, saying it has no interest in meddling with Canada's internal affairs. Chinese President Xi Jinping condemns the so-called U.S.-led suppression of China. In a speech to delegates at an annual congress in Beijing, Xi said Western countries have implemented an all-round containment and suppression of China. Meanwhile, in a press conference on the sidelines of the 14th National People's Congress, Foreign Minister Qin Gang said America's perception of China is seriously distorted. He also asserts the relationship between China and Russia is not any threat to any country. North Korea issues a scathing warning against the U.S. Pyongyang told Washington any move to shoot down one of its test missiles will be considered a declaration of war. The reclusive nation also hinted at more missile tests in the coming weeks. It also blamed the U.S. and South Korea's recent joint military drills for intentionally escalating tensions. On Monday, Washington and Seoul conducted a joint air drill in what has been described as a show of force against Pyongyang's nuclear threat. Four U.S. citizens kidnapped in northern Mexico. Authorities said armed men fired on these Americans shortly after their vehicle crossed the border. Mexico's president believes the Americans entered the country to buy medicine and got caught in a confrontation between criminal groups. The White House says U.S. law enforcement is working with Mexican authorities to find them.
These sorts of attacks are unacceptable. Our thoughts are with the families of these individuals, and we stand ready to provide all appropriate consular assistance. The Departments of State and Homeland Security are also coordinating with Mexican authorities, and we will continue to coordinate with Mexico and push them to bring those responsible to justice.